Welcome to my secret place devotion with Oyeks Alfred. The Word of God is alive and equipped to change your life.
Good morning.
Whether you recognize it or not, there are actually evil attacks that are projected against people on a daily basis. Psalm 91 says that the arrow that flies by day. But then I thank God for 2 Timothy 4:18 that says that the Lord will deliver us from every evil attack and bring us into his heavenly kingdom. So let's pray. Father, thank you for today. Lord, for every arrow that has been released against your people today, I break it in the name of Jesus. No plan that is evil targeted against your children will prosper in the name of Jesus. Amen. If you go to the Bible, Jesus actually placed his children into two categories. In other words, there are two kinds of Christians. The first kind of Christians are foolish Christians, and the second type of Christians are wise Christians. Guess what makes you a wise Christian by God's standards? It's actually what you do with the Word of God. But let's hear directly from the Lord. In Matthew 7:24, Jesus was preaching to his disciples, and he says to them in verse 24 that anyone who listens to my teaching and follows it is wise, like a person who builds a house on solid rock. That's NLT version. But verse 26 says, but anyone who hears my teaching and does not obey it is foolish, like a person who builds a house on sand. So here Jesus categorizes his children into two groups. You have those who have a habit of constantly hearing the Word of God, but then they never do what it says. They just listen to the Word of God, read the Bible for the fun of reading the Bible, but they don't have the intention of putting it into practice. Or whenever they are under pressure, they do what their mind tells them to do, what their body tells them to do, and not what the Word of God says. In other words, they are not under the authority of the Word of God. That means that they are foolish Christians. What Jesus is saying is that they are building their house, their ministry, their career, their finance, their marriage, whatever it is, on sand. He says that whenever the troubles and the challenges of life will come, that house is guaranteed to fall. It will not be able to withstand the pressures of life. For instance, you have a business or you work, and then you constantly falsify figures, you constantly lie, you cheat, you give fake or adulterated products. You might get away with it today, tomorrow, next tomorrow. But the Bible, which is the thing that can never be shaken, the Word of God will last forever. It tells you what will happen to that business that does that. It will collapse. A lot of people are going against the Word of God and expecting things to thrive for them. It doesn't work that way. So you see somebody whose business is not thriving, he goes, he will fast, he will pray, he will give, he will do all of those things. They won't work. They won't change situations. No matter the prophetic declarations over your life, it won't work. The reason is because you are breaking the laws of God. You can't break the laws of God on one end and expect God to still bless your disobedience. So the Bible says if you function like that, you are foolish. You're building your house or whatever it is you're building in disobedience. The Bible says it is standing on sand. It will sink when the challenges and problems of life that are guaranteed to come. You can't live life without challenges. Both the wise and the foolish, they have challenges in life, they have challenges in business, in career, in marriage, whatever. But the difference is that the wise person's house will keep standing no matter what happens, but the foolish person's house will fall when challenges come. So if, for instance, you're building your marriage and you build it according to the Word of God, not according to social media, not according to what your friend says, not according to what you think, not according to what you feel, you do it according to the Word of God, when the challenges of life come, you find out that the marriage will go stronger. It won't be weak. But when you build on sand, meaning that you build on disobedience to the Word of God, meaning that you do not obey the Word of God, you only listen to the Word of God, you only go to church, that's all you do, you don't obey, the Bible says that your house will sink. Now, there is a type of relationship with God which is called the dual relationship with God. What does that mean? It means that these people don't just follow God and call themselves children of God. They are doers of God's word. James chapter 1 verse 22 tells us, he said, but be ye doers of the word and not hearers only, deceiving your own selves. So he says that if you hear the word and you do not do the word of God, you are deceiving your own self. There are people who are God's children, but they are not doers of the word of God. I like the way New Living Translation puts James chapter 1 verse 22. He says, but don't just listen to God's word. You must do what he says. Otherwise, you will only be fooling yourself. James was just reiterating what Jesus had told us in Matthew 7:24. He says, if you listen to the word and do not do the word of God, you are a foolish man. James comes to say, if you listen to the word of God and you don't do the word of God, you are only fooling yourselves. So a foolish Christian is the one that hears the word but does not put it into practice. He has a relationship with God as a child of God, but he's not a doer of God's word. So which one are you? Are you a child of God, or have you gone beyond being a child of God to becoming a doer of the word of God? The blessings of being a doer of the word of God is that you will see the manifold blessing of God automatically operate in your life. See what the word of God says in Deuteronomy 28 verse 1 and 2. If you fully obey the Lord your God and carefully keep all his commands that I'm giving you today, the Lord your God will set you high above all the nations of the world. You will experience all these blessings if you obey the Lord your God. However, what many Christians are doing is they are claiming the promises of God without doing what God said. He said, you will experience all these blessings if and only if, on the condition that you obey the Lord your God. And he begins in verse 3 to list out all the blessings that will happen to people who have a doer relationship with the Lord. These blessings are not for children of God. They are for doers of the word of God. The blessings are many. He says, your towns and your fields will be blessed. Your children and your crops will be blessed. In fact, the list is endless. But these promises are not for the children of God. Who are the children of God? Those who have come into a relationship with the Lord where they've invited Jesus into their heart. However, these people do not obey the word of God. They don't read the word in order to obey. They read the word of God because they want to cover the whole Bible in 1 year. But there are this group of people who read the word of God one verse a day with the intention of obeying it. These are the owners of Bible promises. You cannot be the owner of Bible promises simply because you are a child of God. You only become the owner of a Bible promise because you have moved from just being a child of God. You have now become a doer of the word of God. Thank you so much for listening. God bless you as you begin to do the word of God.
For other life-changing messages, you can now download the app Rev Oyik Speaks from Play Store for Android phone users or Apple Store for iOS users. You can also follow us on Instagram, YouTube, and Telegram, all on the handle Oyik's Alfred. The word.